The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, expressed support for Sisi Namuju, the Rengo Woman Member of Parliament, as she assured the residents that their legislators in good spirits and will soon be with them. She urged the people of Rengo to consider re-electing their leader, saying she is exceptional. Among made the comments during her visit to the district where she launched the Sentai Foundation in Bukoto West on Saturday. During his meeting with editors this morning at the ICT Hub in Nakawa, the Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Bariomusi, reacted to Among's comments, condemning her involvement in two matters that are still before courts of law. Bariomusi said that legislators accused of corruption should carry their cross.
There is a rule of sub judice that when a matter is before court, then we should not rush to comment on such a matter, especially in a manner that can easily bias or influence the judicial officers who are listening to the case.
The speaker's comments come after four legislators, including Busiki County Member of Parliament Paula Kamba, Sisi Namuju, the Rengo Woman Member of Parliament, Yigara East Member of Parliament Michael Mawanda, and Elgon County Legislator Ignatius Mudimi, are facing corruption charges. In the same meeting, Bariomusi warned media practitioners who tarnish Uganda's image in the diaspora. He warned that government will soon come up with a law to counter such practice.
Because they say social media bulungi, but because they say okugenkulakulana yegwanga si yakuteka kwe lyobulimba oba lyobukyayi lyokuvuma abantu naye nga ministry tugenda kuleta teknolojia igenda kutuyamba okufildalinga biki ebifuruma ku social media mu Uganda.
This meeting brought together leaders in Uganda police, editors from various media houses, including Vision Group's editor-in-chief Barbara Kaija, who urged journalists to publish authentic stories.
So we do take responsibility, but it doesn't mean that we should not do our role. Because if we do not do our role, we let down development.
The government's interest in boosting the economy and well-being of the people in Karamoja is the reason it is supporting investment in the region. The most recent is West International Holdings, a new cement and clinker production line run by West International Holding, a Chinese company. According to Mr. Tang Shengui, the proprietor of West International Holdings, in the first phase, the company will invest $300 million, then later an additional $300 million will be invested. The first phase, we will invest 300 and more 300 will be invested when we start serious production at full capacity and will employ 500 people. Alukwe Emmanuel is a mechanic working at the cement company. He is grateful for the benefits so far achieved as a result of this factory.
You know, when you don't have money, everything is difficult. It has helped me to solve some of my problems at home, like taking care of my parents and also some children of mine. I can help them.
Besides being a mechanic, Alukwe says he has attained multiple skills such as welding, electrical works. He also lauds the company for prioritizing safety.
They have the gloves, I have the element and the reflector. Of course, they can help me to avoid accidents.
Karamoja was identified to have big volumes of limestone, which is the main raw material for cement production. The factory will be producing 6,000 tons of clinker and 3,000 tons of cement per day at peak hours. Stone-throwing demonstrators scuffled today with Kenyan police who fired tear gas, rubber bullets and water cannons to disperse thousands of mostly young people protesting proposed tax hikes in the capital Nairobi. The main Legion Z-led rallies, which began last week, have caught the government off guard, with President William Ruto saying he was ready to talk to the protesters over the weekend. The demonstrations have been mostly peaceful, as Ruto noted Sunday in his first public comments on the rallies. But scuffles broke out today in Nairobi as demonstrators threw stones at police to prevent them from heading towards parliament. Despite a heavy police presence, thousands of protesters marched through Nairobi's business district, pushing back against barricades as they marched towards parliament. Police in full riot gear fired tear gas and rubber bullets into the crowd. anger over cost of living crisis spilled into nationwide rallies last week, with demonstrators calling for the finance bill to be scrapped. The cash-strapped government agreed last week to roll back several tax increases, but it still intends to raise other taxes, saying they are necessary to fulfill the state coffers and cutting reliance on external borrowing. The government now intends to target an increase in fuel prices and export taxes to fill the void left by the changes, a move critics say will make life more expensive in a country already saddled with high inflation.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.